दिस इज द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ क्लास फोर साइंस पार्ट्स ऑफ द प्लांट फूड प्रोडक्शन. इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट फंक्शंस ऑफ रूट्स, फंक्शंस ऑफ स्टेम, एंड इन टुडेज टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट पार्ट्स ऑफ अ प्लांट फ्लावर्स. ओके, we are going to discuss the topic flowers. So flowers comprises of the following parts. What are those? The reproductive parts, the pollens and the egg cells. These are the three main important parts of a flower. And these flowers, when they mature, they form into fruits. Flowers mature to form fruits. Okay, so now let's discuss the parts of a flower. Okay, a flower contains four main parts. What are those? First one, sepal, petal, third one, stamen, and the last one is pistil. Pistil. These are the main parts of a plant. Let's see by looking at this picture. Okay, so when you look at this picture, this is the first part of the flower and it is the outermost whorl of the flower, and this whorl of this sepal protects flower when it is as a bud. And let's go to the second one. This is the second whorl of the flower. It is called as petal, and these petals have bright colors. Okay, when you look at this flower has pink color, which attracts or induces the insects for pollination. And next we'll go to the next part, that is, look at these yellow color lines. These are the stamen. Each and every stamen is the third whorl of the flower, and these are the male reproductive parts of the flower. And we'll go to the next one. It is pistil, the middle center part. This is called the pistil, and it is the fourth whorl of the flower, and this is the female reproductive part of the flower. Okay, now let's discuss the functions of a flower. Okay, there are two main functions of a flower. So the first one is, the flower is the reproductive organ of the plant. Okay, the flower is the reproductive organ of a flower. And the second one is, it contains pollen and egg cells. Contains pollen grains and egg cells. Okay, these egg cells later mature to form fruits. They mature to form fruits.
Okay.
We'll go to the next topic in the parts of a plant, that is leaves.
Okay.
When you look at a plant, what do you see? What is the color of the plant? Mostly the plant looks green. So it consists of more number of leaves. Few plants don't have leaves. So what is the color of the leaf? The color of the leaf is green. So most of the plants have leaves. Most plants have leaves. Yes. And what is the color of the leaf? The leaf color is green. It is green in color. It is green in color. Okay. So different kinds of plants have different kinds of leaves. They have different sizes and different shapes. Leaves are of different sizes, different sizes and shapes. Sizes and shapes. Now let's discuss the functions of leaves. Functions of leaves. Okay. What is the main function of the leaf? Leaves prepare food for the plant. Okay. The process by which leaves prepare its food is known as photosynthesis. Leaves prepare food known as by the process known as photosynthesis. Photosynthesis. Okay. And plants, even they respire. Respiration occurs in plants. So how does respiration occurs? Respiration takes place through the small pores which are present in the leaves, underside of the leaves. What are the pores called? They are called as stomata. Respiration occurs through small pores called, or you can write known as stomata. Okay. And we'll come to the next point. As humans respire and they have some other functions, they also excrete some waste products. In the same way, plants also excrete the waste material which is known as water. If excess water is present after the process of photosynthesis, it excretes outside through the same stomata. Okay? Plants excrete. What is the meaning of excrete? Sending out. Okay. Plants excrete excess water. Excess water through the leaves or stomata, you can write. Through the stomata. Okay. And one more last function is,
okay, I'll write here, fourth point.
Most of the, not all the leaves, but few leaves store food in themselves. The food which is prepared by the process of photosynthesis is stored in the leaves. We'll see what are the examples. Leaves also store food. What are the examples of the leaves which store food? Coriander, mint, cabbage, etc. Okay, these are the functions of the leaves. Okay, we'll go to the next topic now. Okay, how do leaves prepare food for plants? Okay, so plants prepare its food by a process known as photosynthesis. So we shall discuss the process of photosynthesis now. Photosynthesis. Okay, what is photosynthesis? Plants use sunlight. Plants absorb carbon dioxide. Where do plants get this carbon dioxide? These plants absorb carbon dioxide through the air, okay, which is mixed in the air through the stomata, and also it absorbs water through the roots, and in the presence of sunlight, and these plants also need, other than sunlight, it needs a pigment called chlorophyll, which is present in the green leaves. So what are the products formed here in the process of the photosynthesis? Here, carbohydrates are formed. What are carbohydrates? The food prepared by the plants is known as glucose, that is only called as carbohydrate. Okay, and it also gives out the excess of gives also some waste products and oxygen is also formed. Okay, this process occurs only during the sunlight. Okay, and this photosynthesis process occurs in the leaves of green plants. Okay, and here the manufacturing of food takes place in the cells. What are those cells called? This all process occurs in a palisade cells. Occurs in palisade cells. So these palisade cells consist of small tiny structures. Okay, they consist of tiny structures called chloroplasts. So these chloroplasts consist of chlorophyll. So this palisade cells are present in the leaves. This palisade cells consist of tiny structures called chloroplasts. Chloroplasts consist of chlorophyll. With the presence of this chlorophyll only, this chlorophyll absorbs the sunlight, energy from the sunlight. absorbs energy, from the sunlight, and it prepares its food, and these products are formed. Okay, so plants prepare its food called carbohydrate, means it is glucose, right? When this carbohydrates are formed in excess quantity, this is stored in the form of starch. So this starch is stored in different parts of plant. As we already discussed in your previous classes, they store in different parts of the plant, like leaves, stems, flowers, fruits, and that all which we take them as vegetables, right? So now we are going to conduct one experiment to know how whether the starch is present in the leaves or not. So what should we do? We should take a beaker and add a pinch of starch powder in this. Okay, this is a beaker. This is starch. When you add pinch of starch in this beaker, add some hot water. Add hot water to this and you stir it well. After stirring, this becomes a starch solution. Starch solution. So cool it for 10 minutes. After cooling it, add few drops of iodine solution to this solution. Okay, what is this iodine? Iodine solution. When we add iodine solution to this starch solution, the starch solution turns into bluish black color. So why did this starch solution change into bluish black color? As this solution, in the solution starch is present, when we add iodine solution, it turns into bluish black color, showing the presence of starch in this. Okay. So in this way, same we'll see an equation like the photosynthesis. Starch solution, when it is added with iodine solution turns into bluish black color, showing the presence of starch in this solution. Okay, in the same way, in your textbook you have an activity in the page number 11. Please do this activity at home with your parents' help. And in the next two pages, page number 12 and 13, you have some exercises. Complete that. And worksheet will be sent through WhatsApp.